tonight. The church is more than a century old, with followers in more than 70 countries. Joining us from Los Angeles, Virginia S. Harris, chairman of the board of directors of the Church of Christian Science. She's next on Larry King Live. Good evening. We got a lot to learn tonight about a church we may not know a lot about, but everyone knows the name, the Christian Science Monitor, Christian Science Reading Rooms. It is official named as the First Church of Christ Scientist, and our guest is the chairman of its board of directors, Virginia S. Harris. Does that mean you are the high priestess, in a sense? Are you the person?
I am not the person, Larry.
Is there a person?
There is not a person. There are four other people besides myself that make up the Christian Science Board of Directors. So five in all. We actually function.
They select you?
Yes, we
do. They vote for
you. They vote. If someone leaves,
Does the chairman serve for a particular amount of time?
No, it's indefinite. And it's actually more of an administrative. I chair the meetings, I sign the legal documents, some of the letters.
Run the newspaper?
Well, we all pitch in and run the newspaper.
Let's get a little historical so we learn more. Who started this church and where?
Started right here in America, New England, Mary Baker Eddy.
A famous name.
In fact, when she passed on in 1910, she was one of the most well-known women in the world.
And what faith was she born into?
She was a Congregationalist and had a strong faith in God, like many New Englanders in those days. We're talking now about the mid-1800s.
It's rock-ribbed.
Rock-ribbed. Father was strong, read the Bible every night, spent all day on Sunday in church.
What led her to start a new church?
She suffered illness most of her life. She tried every possible cure that was known in those days, homeopathy, hydropathy, all sorts of cures. Plus regular medicine, such as it was practiced in those days. And she never quite got permanently well. Then in 1866, she had a serious accident and asked for her Bible. Now, she'd read it all her life. It was a constant companion, but they gave her no hope. And so she opened to the New Testament, so some of Jesus' healings, read those, and began to get well. So it was at that point that was a real turning point in her life, because she realized that what she'd been doing for the first half of her life, and mind you, in 1866, she was 45 years old. She lived to be almost 90. So for the first half of her life, she'd searched. She had this accident, saw that God was a big dimension, was the underlying dimension of spiritual healing. And she went on from there. And 9 years later, she wrote her best-selling book, Science and Health, with Key to the Scriptures. Today is still a bestseller, has been for 90 years. And explaining this healing system.
How did she choose the name the First Church of Christ, comma, Scientist?
It's really something that she came up with because it was a church that followed Christ Jesus' teachings.
Meaning Christ was, in a sense, a scientist?
Yeah, exactly.
And prayer was the science of healing?
Exactly. That there were principles that you could prove in everyday life. Not just miracles that happened every now and then for certain people, but a science that could be practiced and proven.
Why did it eliminate other forms of medical attention?
Well, again,
why couldn't you have prayer and aspirins?
Well, people can do whatever they want to do.
I mean, why didn't she go both ways? Why just?
Well, I think in those days, as you remember, you know, medicine was not what medicine is today. And she didn't need to go both ways because her ability and her understanding of God and the power of prayer to heal was so strong that once she made this discovery, once she began to teach others how to heal, and she was healing, they realized that you didn't need the help of medicine. Prayer was the first resort.
Do most then true Christian scientists not, I know others I've interviewed in the past, and you don't do many interviews, do you?
I don't do many interviews.
But I've interviewed the editor of the Christian Science Monitor some years back, who had never taken an aspirin in his life. He said that most don't do any conventional medicine at all.
I think you'll find that true. They, over time, their foundation is so strong that when their back's up against the wall, they go to what
they trusted. How fast did it grow?
It grew very quickly. At the turn of the century, this century, there was a church opening a week in this country.
No kidding.
No kidding.
When did the paper start?
Paper started in 1908. She was 88 years old.
Why a paper?
Well, she had been attacked a lot in the newspapers. And in 1907, Joseph Pulitzer had the New York World attacked Mrs. Eddy article after
Inventor
article.
Inventor of yellow journalism.
Exactly. Days of yellow journalism. And he attacked her in the newspapers. They brought a lawsuit against her saying she was incompetent, unable to conduct her own affairs. That was all disproven. And the next year she decided that the country needed a newspaper that did not subscribe to yellow journalism. And it started, its motto was to injure no man, but to bless all mankind.
Do you know why she picked the name Monitor? Great name.
It is a great name. It is a great name. I think it's that sense of standing watch and monitoring the news.
But over the years, it became a major one. You've won Pulitzer's, right?
Six.
Yeah. You became a major American newspaper in which Christian Science was just a part of, often not mentioned at all, right?
No. It's a very separate. The church owns it, but it's not a church newspaper. No church doctrine is taught in the newspaper. There's one article with a religious inclination, but it's usually written about a current topic.
And you have a cartoonist who's made a lot of fun of me over the years.
He certainly has.
And that's based in Boston?
Boston.
Okay. Uh-huh. And is that where the church is based?
Our headquarters are in Boston.
You're worldwide?
Worldwide, in 135 countries, members are.
How many Christian Scientists are there? Do we know?
We don't know. We don't know. And what we find is that more people read Science and Health. More people rely on Christian Science Healing than ever set foot inside doors of churches.
So you don't, the number is endless.
I don't know. No.
But you've also, of course, remained, that controversy always remains. Mm-hmm. We'll talk about that and a lot of other things. It's a great pleasure to have with us tonight Virginia S. Harris, Chairman, Board of Directors of the First Church of Christ Scientists, the Christian Scientists. We'll be right back.
Retailers like Amazon.com choose priority mail. Shouldn't you?
The computer's become a stage for the entire planet. Better get a good seat. Hayworth, furniture for what's next.
Now you can make every night a nickel a minute. Introducing Sprint Nickel Nights. Now every night till midnight, every call is just a nickel a minute. It's giving America night fever and savings that make every night the right time to talk. Catch night fever for yourself. Call now and get Sprint Nickel Nights. Call 1-877-4-NIGHTS. Switch to Sprint now, and every night you can call all you want at the time that's best for you without having to dial all those extra 1010 numbers. Call 1-877-4-NIGHTS and get Sprint Nickel Nights for night after night of long distance your way. Just 5 cents a minute every night of the week. Catch night fever and make every night your time to call. Switch to Sprint Nickel Nights. Call 1-877-4-NIGHTS now or visit the Sprint store at Radio Shack and catch night fever right now.
It's great to have with us Virginia S. Harris, Chairman, Board of Directors, the First Church of Christ Scientists. Okay, there's lots of controversies and other aspects, and we want to touch all the bases. I guess the most criticism has come when a Christian Science parent has a child die and didn't treat the child. It's been played on Law and Order as an example, etc. How do you deal with that? A child has 103 fever, and the Christian Science parents say, don't give it the antibiotic. We'll pray. And sometimes the prayer fails, and the child dies, And the society says they're all our children. That's the concept of society. Mm-hmm. How do you react?
I'm saddened. Anytime a child dies is tragic, Larry, whether they're shot in a school ground, whether they die in an earthquake, in a hospital under a pediatrician's care, or under the care of a Christian Science practitioner. A child's death is probably the hardest thing that we have to deal with. No one wants that. I'm a mother of three boys, and that's like the hardest thing that anybody can imagine. But basically, every parent wants to give their child the very best care, the very best of everything, the best schooling, the best everything. So a parent, like any other parent, is going to choose the health care that they can rely on, whether it's this pediatrician, this medication or that medication, or Christian Science treatment. They will choose that if they have seen, probably over the lives of many generations in their family, it is effective. No health care is 100% risk-free. We wish it were when it comes to children.
So you're saying, and you yourself practice it fully.
I do, raised our children.
You take no medications, right? Is that true? No, you wouldn't take an aspirin for a headache.
No, because I can heal it with prayer.
Okay. So if your boy, had the 103 fever, you would reject the antibiotic.
Well, it's not a rejection. It's not resistance to medicine, but it's reliance on God, because I would have seen all the proofs in the past with the boys. And we had, as I say, three boys. They had sports injuries. They had all the childhood diseases. But each one of them was cured very, very quickly.
With no injections?
No, nothing. Nothing.
No vaccines?
No. Not unless you're traveling out of the country and the law requires you to.
If the law requires it, you have to obey the law.
Yes. Yes.
So whatever happens, have you been tested? You've been tested. Your own boys had mumps,
mm-hmm.
No treatment.
Healed.
What
Chicken
are practitioners? Pox. You said Christian Science, right? What are they?
I'm a Christian Science practitioner.
Meaning,
that's someone who is available to treat anyone through spiritual means, through spiritual healing, as understood and practiced.
By touching?
No touching. No laying on of hands. Through basically prayer is the form of treatment.
It's, what do you think of the Oral Robertses and the like who go to these large conclaves and touch people and cure them? You would have to believe that.
I do. I admire and respect anyone that's healing, anyone that's doing anything to better mankind, whether it's a doctor.
I guess what confounds people is, why not prayer and the antibiotic?
Yeah. Yeah.
Well, I mean,
I'm asked that question.
It's so logical.
I know. I'm asked that question all the time. And people do that, Larry. People are free to do whatever they want to do.
You're not thrown out of the church.
Not at all. There's nothing in the church that would say you cannot do this and you're not thrown out. No, nothing like that.
Have people, though, had their children die and suddenly regretted their belief and turned against the church and gotten angry by having a child die by doing nothing other than the practitioner? Had to have happened.
People get angry. People get angry when a child dies in a hospital.
But not when they've tried everything. I mean, you get angry, but
well,
not.
Well, yeah, but when I have a child's case, I give it my all, just like any pediatrician.
But they take a strong stand against you.
The pediatricians?
Association does.
Their association. But
well,
I have a lot of.
Well, naturally they would.
I have a lot of good friends that are pediatricians.
Don't they argue with you?
No.
They don't say?
No. In fact, we have wonderful discussions. A lot of the doctors are wanting to learn more about spiritual healing because they're beginning to see what's happening in this country.
Oh, we've talked about it. I did a book on it, and people's
exactly.
Doctors swore by prayer. But I didn't have any doctor say prayer instead of,
mm-hmm.
or prayer regardless of anything else.
Mm-hmm.
So it would seem that the country would look upon aghast at someone not treating their child right. And you've had to put up with this over the
mm-hmm.
years.
Mm-hmm.
So you deal with it just by explaining it's your faith.
Yes, but we do deal with it by saying that the few cases that have been publicized are the only ones. There are very few. Thousands of children are healed every day of things that the
like
doctors
what
have given
you
up.
Seen? What have
well,
you
let
seen?
Me tell you about a case. In my practice, I had a 14-year-old girl. Her mother came to the door of my office. They were not Christian Scientists. The doctors had said there was no hope. The only thing they could do was perform a very specialized surgery, and the chances of her surviving the surgery would be 50%. Then if she did survive, they'd have to give her another operation. And this mother said, I remember something about Christian Science and healing. Can you heal my daughter? I said, well, I'd love to talk to her. Well, to make a long story short, Larry, that was in August. And by Thanksgiving, this young girl was completely healed. Now, they weren't Christian Scientists. She had never been much interested in God, but she was healed. And this kind of thing happens, and it happens quietly all over the world in all these cultures.
In the 1980s, I'm told there were 7 prosecutions of Christian Science parents for manslaughter or neglect and the deaths of their children. Out of it, 5 were convicted, 1 was acquitted, and 1 case was dismissed. When there are convictions and you lose appeals, does that ever cause you to doubt? I mean, the state puts away someone for neglect?
It never causes me to doubt. It causes me, as I say, sadness, but it doesn't cause me to doubt. I have seen too many proofs in my own life. But again, a parent is always free to choose whatever they want to do with that child.
So it's not drummed into them?
No, not drummed into them at all.
Is a Christian Science service similar to other Christian services?
Yes.
On a Sunday morning?
On a Sunday morning it is. Yes, there's a sermon read from the Bible and from Science and Health with Key to the Scriptures by Mary Baker Eddy. Hymns are sung, silent prayer, the Lord's Prayer is said in unison. Collections are even taken.
Celebrate Christmas and holidays. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. We'll be right back with Virginia S. Harris. Don't go away.
It processes endless information, handles multiple tasks at once, and runs at top speed all day. It's your brain, upgraded by Ginkgo ME, the new mental energy supplement, clinically proven to help increase mental processing speed and reduce mental fatigue. Ginkgo ME safely increases circulation to the brain, so you can think faster, longer, better. Use new Ginkgo ME and upgrade your brain.
At Fidelity.com.
What if you could identify the very best stocks in just minutes? Investor's Business Daily does that for you every day with the all-new IBD Smart Select Corporate Ratings. Smart Select Ratings help you zero in on stocks with the strongest investment potential. Now you can quickly compare all stocks by 5 important ratings: earnings growth, price performance, industry performance, sales and profits. Plus a rating that tells you if a stock is being heavily bought or sold by professional investors. 5 proprietary ratings to help you select stocks like the professionals do. Not only will you get a better reading on each stock, but IBD's Big Picture column interprets the key general market information for you each day. Call now, 1-800-943-6819, and receive 2 weeks of Investor's Business Daily absolutely free, plus the free video Maximizing Your Success. Call 1-800-943-6819 today and make investing easier.
We're back with Virginia Harris. You had an accident yourself, right?
I did.
And what happened?
Well, it was about 20 years ago, and it was a major turning point in my life. I had just dropped our 3 boys off at school, and what took about 2 weeks to do, I'll tell you in about 2 minutes. Dropped the boys off at school. I was on my way home, crossing a major 4-lane intersection. 4 cars totally demolished. It took them 45 minutes to get me out of my car.
In Boston as well?
This was in Detroit. We were living in Detroit at the time. And that whole time, I was trapped in the car. Now, here's a case where no medical aid could get to me. No one could get to me. So the only resort I had, Larry, was to pray. And pray I did, because I felt that I knew the injuries were serious. And I thought, if I don't pray, there's nothing else helping me. It's God and me in this car. And I prayed to stay conscious. I was in and out of consciousness. And I felt a wonderful sense of God's care, God's assurance, God's love. And I prayed for the people in the other cars. Well, we were all taken to the emergency room of a local hospital. And there they put the IVs in, and the doctors, doctors, they just do it immediately. And the doctors took one look at me and felt that the internal injuries and the other injuries I sustained would be fatal. They didn't give me much hope to live.
So no medicine was put in the intravenous needle?
No, I don't believe so. No. They called my husband. He was there. He called a Christian Science practitioner to pray for me. And with not much hope given there, I had a conviction at that moment that God would save me. I felt that sense of peace. I felt his care. I felt his closeness. And we decided to take me home.
But I guess you had internal bleeding. That would be one of the, how would that stop without going into you surgically?
How do things happen like that? Prayer can and does reconstruct the body.
Does it cause you to wonder why that lady who might have happened to in Detroit yesterday, who may have prayed, died?
No.
Does that cause you to question God? Why you and not her?
I know. Those are very difficult things to explain.
Faith is hard to explain.
Faith is hard, exactly.
It requires a leap.
It does.
That you fully believe.
It does.
That you feel has been tested.
In my case, it has. Would I do that again? I think I would, but I can't say for sure what I'd do.
I mean, God forbid your boy is shot at school. This would be, 20 years ago, this would be considered a weird hypothetical.
Exactly.
And the doctors call you up and say, we've got to go in. We got to get anticoagulants. He's losing blood. You would say no.
I don't know what I'd say, Larry. I really don't.
It's honest enough.
I really don't know what I'd say. I don't know what I'd do if something like that happened. I would think I would trust God, but I can't say what I'd do.
Why not a simpler thing as an aspirin for a headache? In other words, what in Eddie's concept years ago, what does one have to do with the other? Like just taking care of an immediate relief of a pain with an aspirin, the wonder drug of all time.
Right. Well, it works for lots of people.
You wouldn't take one.
I wouldn't need to take one. I have headaches.
What do you do when you have a headache?
I pray. And it can go away in a minute. What's interesting to see is that 60 to 90% of the illnesses that go into a doctor's office today, they say are stress related and can be cured without medicine and without surgery. And most of these are headaches.
We'll be back with Virginia Harris on Larry King Live. Don't go away.
When they told me that I was HIV positive, that was the single worst moment in my life.
When AIDS was discovered 17 years ago, pharmaceutical companies started immediately looking for treatments.
I was terrified. It finally hit me as I was going into the hospital. I did not want to die.
Pharmaceutical company researchers worked around the clock looking for something that would make a major impact.
If I didn't have this new medicine, I would not be here. It is as simple as that.
Since the advent of protease inhibitors into the combination therapy, AIDS mortality in the U.S. has been reduced by about 50%.
I really do believe that there can be a cure.
I would hope that my place in the universe is to give my best to improve humankind all over the world.
Cars aren't the only products that make the Michigan economy cook.
24 tax cuts in the last 6 years has Michigan businesses sitting very comfortably.
Site Selection magazine has diagnosed us number one in the U.S. for attracting new business growth.
The networking's great.
Call 1-800-946-6829 for information about Michigan's great location.
Today it's not enough to be just computer smart. You've also got to be state smart.
We're back with Virginia S. Harris of Christian Science and their famed publication, The Christian Science Monitor. We'll talk a little bit more about that later as well. This horse drives me nuts. Whenever I go into a town that's kind of rich, Greenwich, Connecticut, words we didn't say as kids because we were too poor.
Right.
There's a Christian Science reading room, and the two things are going on. Nobody's in there. and there's books in the window. What is that? I'm not kidding.
I know, that's
this is
wonderful.
Like you have. It looks like you have as many as Starbucks, except you're only in wealthy cities. I never saw you in a flat mall. You know, you're not next to You Totem in the flat mall across from the McDonald's. What a
well, we're going to be in some malls soon. Right,
what are Christian Science reading?
Christian Science reading rooms are in about 2,200 cities.
You're kidding.
I'm not kidding.
Okay, I only see them in like wealthy.
That's the only places you're going, Larry.
You might have a point. Yeah. And the purpose is what?
They are
reading rooms?
They are reading rooms. They are there for the public.
You can buy books there?
You can buy Bibles. You can buy books. You can buy the Christian Science Monitor there. You can buy books for children. You can buy all sorts of books.
And people do come in.
People do come in.
Does the church lose money? I know you lost money on your television enterprise. You tried a cable network. That didn't work. Maybe you were ahead of your time. Think maybe too soon?
Probably.
Does the paper make money?
The paper doesn't make money. Paper does well, but we do subsidize the paper. Like to know the day that we don't have to, but we do right now.
And that your money comes from, are you tithed?
We don't tithe particularly, but people give. 50% of our money comes from contributions by members and by people that
and
have been healed
to
by
Christians. Like you lose $22 million a year, it's been reported, the paper. Mm-hmm. They're willing to absorb that loss, the members of the church.
Oh, yes, they see it as a wonderful, wonderful gift to mankind. That standard of journalism, they feel very much needs to be there today to bring that sense of education, that sense of enlightenment, answers to problems.
So you're proud of that paper,
obviously. We're very proud of that paper.
Do you get Medicare money? Does practitioners get Medicare?
No, Medicare money does not go to practitioners. Some Medicare money would go to individuals who are on Medicare if they're receiving non-medical nursing.
I see. You're coming over to take care of the elderly.
Right.
But prescription.
Not for prayer.
They're not paid for prayer. They're paid for caring.
That's right. For the physical care like anyone would get in a nursing home. To be bathed, fed, that kind of thing.
So you have, except for that intravenous shot when you were brought in from the ambulance, never had a shot?
I did as a child. My father was not a Christian Scientist. So I grew up.
You had the vaccines.
I had penicillin.
Do you ever wonder, is God looking down at that ill person and listening? A figure somewhere is doing that? Do you think that's happening?
Yeah, I think that probably not looking down. I think he's probably right here. I think God is as present as the very air we breathe.
But you don't question why this loving God cures him and takes her.
I scratch my head about that.
When you see massive death, hurricanes, earthquakes, famine, holocausts, how do you deal with that emotionally?
Prayer's always my first resort.
You would doubt and say, what are you doing?
Oh. Yeah. You sometimes wonder, but you know instinctively that God is there despite the horror of the moment. And we can see wonderful opportunities where God does shine through. Sometimes those things that are so tragic bring wonderful blessings. We hate to see the loss of life, but to see the human spirit rise up and help people bring together.
Since God is everywhere, though, wouldn't he be also at the pharmaceutical company? And if we're living now into our 70s, when we were dying in our 60s because of things like antibiotics and other amazing drugs that keep people alive who would normally be dead, can't we assume that God invented that? Or played a part in whoever did invent it?
Well, sure. You know, I mean, God.
So if he's present in the healing, he's present in the cure.
And if that's what somebody wants to believe, then.
You don't believe that?
Well, I believe that he is so present without any other aid.
So under your belief, we don't need the pharmaceutical laboratory. That's a waste of money.
If everyone had that understanding. But Larry, everyone's at different points on their journey.
Let me pick that up in a minute. My guest is Virginia S. Harris, a rare appearance. We're happy to have her. She's chairman, board of directors of the First Church of Christ Scientists. This is Larry King Live. Don't go away.
Tonight, the nuclear accident in Japan. What happened, and was there any way to prepare for it? CNN Newsstand, tonight 10, 9 Central on CNN.
Nothing should keep you from providing your child with the best medical care available. And at Shriners Hospitals, nothing will. Shriners Hospitals for Children offers some of the world's best medical care to kids with orthopedic problems or severe burns totally without charge. No cost, no catch. If you know a child with problems with the bones, joints, or muscles, or with severe burns, call this number for more information. Shriners, helping kids. The tradition continues.
NBC 30 Connecticut News, live, local, late-breaking. Proving it every day with the most experienced team of reporters and anchors covering Connecticut.
This breaking news just in.
We're live with a story you'll see only on NBC 30.
Uncovering the stories.
And in an exclusive interview,
NBC 30, always on the scene when news breaks with details you want to know.
As NBC 30 was first to report.
When the story's breaking, watch NBC 30 Connecticut News, live, local, late-breaking.
Sports Tonight with Fred and Vince, 11 Eastern on CNN.
We're back with Virginia S. Harris of the First Church of Christ Scientists. She is chairman of its board of directors. Concerning Medicare, we're told that the $8 million was given to 22 Christian Science facilities for patient services last year, and there's a lawsuit being appealed regarding those payments. Is that right? Where does that stand? You know?
It's on appeal.
Did you lose the original?
We won.
Who won the other, and who's appealing?
The people that are filing suit.
Saying that you shouldn't get any Medicare. When someone's have a heart attack, they're in the hospital, they're having a heart attack, they're a Christian Scientist, they tell the physician, right?
Mm-hmm.
If they're knocked out, unconscious, physician doesn't know he's going to treat them, right?
Right.
I mean, if someone is whacked,
sure,
knocked out,
sure,
they're brought into a hospital with a heart attack and they lose consciousness, they're going to be treated.
They're going to be treated,
or
exactly.
Whatever. But if they're not and they say, I'm a Christian Scientist, what does the person from the church do when they come to the hospital?
Well, they would come and visit them. They, depending on what they want to do, again, a practitioner is free to pray for someone, love them, care for them.
But you would decline bypass surgery for blocked arteries.
Me, myself?
Yeah. And true Christian scientists would.
If they felt that their faith and their understanding, Larry, was strong enough, they might do that.
By the way, does the church have a stand on abortion?
No. As a board of directors, I really don't speak out publicly on those kind of statements. The Monitor comments through our editorials and through our pages. We'll often make comments on social
What's
issues.
What's their stand on it?
Well, we don't take a public stand on
Paper's it. Considered progressive, though, isn't it?
Yeah, it is.
And it's social policy, but pro-civil rights. It's been, right, hasn't it? Over the years, it's been a hallmark of those areas. Because abortion is not.
There may be
medicine used, right?
If it's a surgical operation.
Yeah. How about orthodontists? For teeth.
Yeah. Sure.
That's okay.
You can have your teeth cleaned.
You can have braces put on.
Sort of a mechanical thing. You have your hair cut.
So all Christian Science kids aren't walking around with crooked teeth.
That's right. Okay.
Cosmetic surgery.
Well, if somebody felt that that's what they wanted to do, they're free to do what they want to do.
All right. There's a book out, Critical of the Church. I want to ask you about it. It's by Carolyn Frazier, and she calls it God's Perfect Child, Living and Dying in the Christian Science Church, from Metropolitan Books. She was raised a Christian Scientist, is a Harvard PhD, writes for The New Yorker and New York Review of Books, and she attacks the church for practices and ethics. She examines the church beginnings, eccentricity of its founder, writes that the church teaches members to believe that all illness is an error and to shun all medical treatment, and likens it to half-forgotten an old character at a crowded party, elbowed aside by dozens of others. How do you react to something like that?
I'm very saddened.
Do you know her?
I did an interview with her.
She interviewed you for the book? Are you quoted in the book? I haven't read the book.
Yeah, I'm quoted in the book.
Fairly, unfairly, accurate?
Unfairly. The book is filled with inaccuracies, Larry.
Like? Well,
you take the first section on Mary Baker Eddy, and in the preface, the author says that she's setting out to write a book critical of Christian Science, and uh, the the inaccuracies on Mary Baker Eddy are based primarily on a very critical book written about Mrs. Eddy at the turn of the century, which through scholarship and biographies through the decades have totally been proven disproved, invalidated. She didn't seek any primary sources when she went to write on Mary Baker Eddy. So it was a troubled book. She set out to write something critical.
Did she fool you? Because she wouldn't have given the interview if you thought she was, that's the way she was going. What did she say when she approached you?
Well, she said that she was wanting to be open and write a fair book about the church, and that she'd had a very unhappy childhood growing up as a Christian Scientist. And that's very different than my upbringing as a Christian Scientist, attending a Christian Science Sunday school. And my heart went out to her. It really did. And so I granted her a two-hour interview to see if I couldn't help alleviate some of the anger that appeared to be there.
Were you surprised at the book? Well, you saw the anger, so you couldn't have been shocked,
yeah.
Right?
No, I think I was, as I say, saddened, disappointed. She looks at the church through that critical lens, not at all looking at where the church is going, not looking into the 21st century, not looking at any of the good that's being accomplished with spiritual healing and alternative means. She takes a real side swipe at all of the alternative healing that's going on today.
Alternative like?
Well, prayer, meditation, relaxation.
How about herbals?
Yeah, she...
Does Christian Science accept taking herbals, which are not prescription, they're not drugs?
Right, right. Well,
I mean, they're natural products.
That's right. And again, a Christian Scientist will be free to do whatever...
Would you take an herbal product?
I love herb tea.
No, I mean...
yeah, now
mean
probably
herb, extract,
not.
Extract herb, but no?
No.
So you would put no, what you would call foreign bodies into your body, right?
Probably okay. Not.
How about processed food?
Well, just about all the food's processed. Yeah, unless we can get, yeah, exactly.
Only, right? Exactly. So you can't, you're not vegetarians?
No, I'm not.
Right. Are there, as you see it, any hypocrisies in your own thinking where you question, for example, every church has certain things where the Jew says, well, yeah, I understand about pigs, but that was because it was 2,000 years ago and mm-hmm. it was dangerous mm-hmm. to eat pork. And the Mormons question, well, yeah, caffeine, but do they mean Coca-Cola or they just mean coffee? Do you question anything about Christian Science?
I don't, and I haven't.
You're amazing. You don't.
I don't, because it's worked. And I just every day try to understand more about it. It's a wonderful model for living.
But there are the frightening moments that everyone must face. Parents, okay, you want to live that way for yourself, but isn't it difficult when you're making a choice for a three-year-old?
It's always difficult.
When you want to do it for yourself,
yeah,
fine.
Sure, but it's always difficult. Go to the right pediatrician? Did we go to the right hospital? This pediatrician says, we want to treat your son with this. Do you ever wonder, gosh, and they tell you it's a potent drug, Larry, and that might have side effects.
I hope he's right. I hope it works.
Well, you hope it works.
But you're going to go to
but
the
you
drug.
Know,
I mean...
Well, but God bless you, and I respect that.
I respect you not. The hard part is what the state has to do when it's a parent and a child,
course,
and the difficulty
course,
a judge
of
faces
course,
in that
of
situation.
Course. And our society is having to wrestle that through. Who's caring for America's children? The state or the parent?
Well, one of the concepts is they're all our children. The state can remove a child from a house
that's
who's battered. I mean, a parent could say, it's my right to hit the kid. You got no right to take that kid away. But the state has determined it does have the
right. That's right.
And has there been cases where the state has done surgery on a child over a parent's objections? Do you know?
I don't know that.
I wonder if that's happened.
Yeah, I don't
where
know
the parents
that.
Say no and the doctor says, well, let's go in and do
know.
It.
I don't know that. Well, not that I'm aware of.
We'll be right back with Virginia S. Harris. Lots more to talk about. Don't go away.
One small step for man.
The high roads of the future.
The only thing we have to fear is fear itself.
Night time.
live theater. There's something that happens in the live theater that's scary, that's unexpected, that's always surprising, and you can't get that in any other medium.
I'd blow the pyramids to bits, desecrate a shrine.
I fell in love with it at a very, very young age. I was 9 years old, so it's such a powerful thing. It's almost like breathing for me.
It was a wonderful thing to walk into a place and know that you absolutely belong there and nowhere else.
It's taught me a lot about people. It's taught me a lot about myself, which allows me to understand others a lot better. Obviously, you work with the director very closely in the beginning, but once he lets the play go and it becomes yours and the audience, it's you and them. And that's very, very rewarding. It's almost like you're levitating. It doesn't happen every night, but when it does, it's extraordinary.
This Voices of the Millennium is brought to you by Zales, the diamond store. Forever starts today with a diamond from Zales.
Zales reminds you that a new millennium only comes along once every 1,000 years. And if you've had the good fortune to have fallen in love at this time, there's only one way to mark the occasion. With the Diamond Solitaire from the Zales Signature Collection, an exquisite single diamond is a powerful gift. It has the power to take two people and make them one. At Zales stores nationwide or shop online at Zales.com.
Online investors say execution is the most important criterion for choosing a broker. So, who's executing your trades? Knight, the world's leading market maker, where the trade gets done.
Shoppers everywhere trust their bargain hunting to GTE. Thousands of builders trust their reputations to Boise Cascade. Millions of people trust their entertainment to the MGM Grand. When it comes to your organization's network, who are you going to trust? Cabletron Systems, your e-business communication specialist.
When it comes to executing trades, who is the preferred choice of the top online brokers? Knight, the world's leading market maker, where the trade gets done.
We're back with Virginia Harris. One other critical book, and I want to talk about other things. Gillian Gill wrote a biography.
Yes, she did.
Of, I guess that would be, did you consider it critical, the biography of Mary Baker Eddy?
No, it's very good. She spent 7 years researching primary sources. She's a Oxford scholar. It's a very fair book.
She said that she got her concept from a faith healer, Dr. Phineas Quimby. Mm-hmm. Does your research tell you the same thing?
Mrs. Eddy worked with Phineas Quimby, learned many things from him, but realized that he didn't take God into consideration as much as she felt God was, and she went on to found Christian Science after her encounter with him.
Did people consider her quacky? I mean, when she started to get well known and people started going into this, did society say, do you know the lady that doesn't believe in medicine?
I think sometimes...
All religious begin as well.
Exactly.
They kill the famous one.
Exactly. Anytime someone steps out from the pack, they're subject to criticism.
Why do people get angry at the church? You think it's due to the children aspect? I mean, there are people, I mean, there's a lot of people love this church and there's many, many members worldwide, but there are some people get vitriolic about it, really angry about it. Why do you think?
Yeah. I think probably they don't truly understand. Somehow they don't understand what it's about, or they've had a misencounter through something.
Well, they've lost someone?
They could have, sure.
How does the board get chosen?
Self-perpetuating board. When a vacancy occurs, the remaining board members elect.
From someone in the church?
Yes, yes. Anyone can be a board.
How did you come to the board? What were you doing at the time? Is the board a full-time job for you?
The board is a full-time job.
All five members work full-time?
All five members work full-time. We all live right in Boston.
And the chairman obviously works full-time.
Yes.
What were you doing before you got on the board?
I was working at the headquarters. I was overseeing all, I was clerk at the church, overseeing the field activities, the churches, the reading rooms, the Sunday schools, the chaplains, that kind of thing. And then when there was a vacancy, I was elected to step onto the board.
Would you call yourself a strong, are you, there's one critic, I don't know the name, who said that you rule that board. That's the Harris board.
Oh, well, all five of us are equal. Everyone has the same vote.
Are there 3-2 votes on things? Does Harris ever lose a discussion?
Oh, sure. We all try to come out as one.
Okay, so that's
those
stories
thing.
Are not true.
Those stories are not true.
We'll be right back with Virginia S. Harris. We'll talk about the Monitor right after this.
You want to see some action?
Definitely.
Rolling Stone says, when it comes to rousing action, whip smart laughs and moral uplift that doesn't pump sunshine up your... Three Kings rules. Best movie of the year talk has already begun.
All right.
George Clooney, Mark Wahlberg, Ice Cube, Three Kings.
We three kings be stealing the gold.
Rated R. Starts Friday, October 1st.
For the first time in history, a personal computer has been classified as a weapon by the U.S. government. With the power to perform over 1 billion calculations per second, the Pentagon wants to ensure that the new Power Macintosh G4 does not fall into the wrong hands. As for Pentium PCs, well, they're harmless.
At 25, I wanted to make vice president. At 35, I wanted to make my first million. At 45, I wanted to make enough to buy the company. Now all I want is to make it around this track 0.2 seconds faster.
At Lincoln Financial Group, we provide clear, understandable, customized solutions to help you manage, protect, and enjoy the work of a lifetime. Lincoln Financial Group, clear solutions in a complex world.
Sunday on an all-new CNN and Time. These parents believe a routine vaccination caused their son's autism.
I mean, he was doing great until June, until the shot.
Most of the medical community disagrees.
There is no substantial evidence that measles, mumps, and rubella vaccine causes autism.
The growing controversy over how and when children should be vaccinated. CNN and Time, Sunday 9 Eastern on CNN.
We mentioned earlier during the interview about 7 prosecutions of Christian Science parents for manslaughter or neglect, in which we said there were 5 convictions, an acquittal and a dismissal. And Virginia tells us that all were overturned.
Mm-hmm. Two acquittals.
Two acquittals, all overturned. So no one went to jail
for
letting their children, either neglect or manslaughter, die in the face of this. Okay, 1 of 5. No, it was a source. Someone had a source inside the church that this was the quote from the source. I don't know who the source was, but I rely on the producer, that Virginia Harris is clearly the dominant figure. She calls all the shots.
Absolutely not true. All five of us are equal.
The other four board members would faint at hearing this.
They would faint, and I would faint. I'm fainting at hearing it.
Who runs the Monitor?
The editor, managing editor.
The board picks them?
The board picks them. The board appoints the editor. And then the editor hires the rest of the staff.
But the board does not influence editorially the paper?
No, we have an editor. The board has cabinet positions, Larry. And there is one board member who is manager of the publishing society, and he oversees the business and editorial side. So, yes, he does review every day the editorials and the cartoons.
So he approved the cartoons?
He approved the cartoons about you.
But he can say, don't run this?
Yes, okay. Yes.
Has that happened a lot?
I don't think
it happens. Editors have usually been people, the ones I've met have been independent.
Very independent. And there's that journalism integrity and distinctness. As I say, we don't use
that. Still got a lot of interns, still a lot of people who want to work at the Christian Science Monitor. It's like a goal, like the New York Times
or
the Washington Post.
It is. We've got a great group of kids there this summer.
The National Paper. Right?
The National Paper.
Why didn't the TV work, do you think? We said it may have been ahead of its time.
I think it was the timing. I think it was the timing. It was a tremendous loss to journalism. We put our heart and soul into it because we so believe in Monitor journalism and the standard.
Yeah, because you didn't proselytize the faith.
Not at all. No, we had great people. You probably know a lot of them.
Many of them
that worked with us, and they gave it their heart. The spirit of Monitor journalism so permeated that endeavor. But it was at the time when we were just going into the multi-channels.
CNN was starting.
Exactly. Same time.
So you had some fierce competition early on, right?
Fierce competition.
And you were also, like the paper, you weren't glitzy.
Right.
Would you admit that?
Right.
You didn't have fancy graphics.
No. Heart and soul publication.
You think you might return to television?
Well, Mary Baker Eddy told us to always keep the periodicals abreast of the times. It's a mandate that the board lives with. So the world's getting their news on television, but the Monitor is doing well on the internet, ChristianScienceMonitor.com, lots of hits. So that's a way that we're keeping it abreast of the times.
No one, I would imagine, affects the front page, right?
No.
If there's a story, the Monitor runs it.
That's right.
If it was a story that involved a church that may have been a legal story, mm-hmm. you would print it.
We would print it.
So there's no favoritism.
No favoritism. Sometimes I wish there was.
At a service, is there a bishop, a minister? Who's in charge?
There is no ordained clergy.
So what happens?
The pastor of the church is the Bible and Science and Health. So if you were to walk in a local Christian Science church somewhere, you would see two members of that congregation who've been elected by the congregation who are lay readers conducting the service on Sunday. And on Wednesday night, one of them, the first reader, does. And
they do the sermons?
The sermons are made by a committee that produces them, and the same sermon is read in Christian Science churches around the world.
Are there blacks in the Christian Science movement?
Mm-hmm.
White, touch all bases?
All cultures.
All continents.
Larry, 174 countries, 135 countries, excuse me, 74 countries with churches, all cultures.
Back with our remaining moments with Virginia S. Harris, Chairman, Board of Directors, the First Church of Christ Scientists. Don't go away.
Flexible metal frame. Flexon by Marshawn.
At Oldie, we see every client as unique. Take Mary Ryan, university librarian and former customer of a full-cost broker. Should research her own investments, but who has time? Mary switched to Oldie because for the last 4 years, Oldie analysts have been members of the Wall Street Journal's All-Star Analyst Team. And Oldie's research and advice come with dramatic commission savings over full-cost firms. Spend your time focused on life. Call Oldie, America's full-service discount broker.
Get the world and business news you need to get a jump on your day. Quick, smart. Comprehensive. Stay ahead of the curve. Premieres Monday, 5 to 7 Eastern on CNN.
We're back with our remaining moments with Virginia Harris, Chairman of the Board of Directors of the First Church of Christ Scientists. What's the future like as we approach the millennium here? What's the growth picture?
I think it's absolutely going to burst. This growing trend and the passion for spirituality and spiritual healing that we're seeing not only in America but in countries all over the world, I think will continue to renew the interest in Christian Science. The sales of Science and Health, explaining spiritual healing, has been on the rise for the last 5 years, like so many books on spirituality and healing. The discussion of seeing more and more Americans wanting to be involved in spiritual healing. 42% of these people are looking for this. This is what we've been doing for 125 years, Larry.
Yeah. Do you draw people from all faiths?
Yes, yes.
Since new Christian Scientists have to come from somewhere, either agnosticism, atheism, Judaism, right, Christianity,
right,
whatever.
Right, 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 right.
They come from all faiths.
They come from all faiths. And whether or not they join the church, many of them read Science and Health and go back and be a better Jew or a better Baptist or a better Catholic. They take the teachings of Christian Science back into some of the churches that they belong to. It's for anyone.
All faith can be painful, right? So there had to have been times where it's painful for Virginia Harris, as you said, to read of a death or things that could have happened in your own family. Is your faith the help that overcomes that? I mean, do you pray, obviously, in the non-health area as well?
Yes, about anything.
And you believe those prayers are answered, sometimes negatively, right?
Sure. God sometimes says no.
Yeah.
Right, exactly. And we ought to listen when he says no just as much as when he says go.
Do you read from the New Testament?
Both Old and New Testaments.
And the Eddy book.
And Science and Health by Mary Baker Eddy.
That is considered, as, in a sense, the Bible of your church?
No, the Bible's very important in our church. It's the key to the Scriptures. To many people, it unlocks the Scriptures. To many people who never understood the Bible, Science and Health will do that for them.
Are all three of your children Christian Scientists?
Yes.
A little hesitancy?
They're grown men.
I see.
They're grown. They're
grown men.
I have three grown sons. I have two grandsons.
Are they Christian Scientists?
They're a little.
Thanks, Virginia.
Wonderful to be here.
Thanks for appearing with us. Virginia S. Harris, Chairman, Board of Directors, the First Church of Christ Scientist, and main base Boston. They're all over the world. You know them as Christians. We thank her for being with us. We thank you for joining us. Good night.
Tonight, the nuclear accident in Japan. What happened, and was there any way to prepare for it? CNN Newsstand, tonight 10, 9 Central on CNN.
Only one network delivers more golf than anywhere else.
The Golf Channel brings you everything you want to know, watch, and enjoy from past and present in the world of golf.
More live call-in golf chat.
And instruction with top teaching professionals. More up-to-the-minute nightly golf news, worldwide tournaments, plus early round coverage of premier PGA Tour events.
And much more. The Golf Channel. More golf.
At Auto World's Planet Hyundai Superstore, dare to compare. Toyota 5-year, 60,000 miles. Mazda 3-year, 50,000 miles. Honda 3-year, 36,000 miles. Hyundai Advantage, 10 years, 100,000 miles. Just think, it's 2002, and your Honda warranty has expired, while Hyundai owners are still covered until 2009. It's America's value, backed by America's best warranty. Come into Auto World's Planet Hyundai Superstore and ask about the Hyundai Advantage, exit 33 off I-91.
The next time you visit your favorite restaurant or grocery store, be sure to look for Cable Rep Advertising's contest entry box. Cable Rep Advertising and Cox Communications are giving away a free dinner for a group of two or four, plus four free movie tickets. It's easy to win. Just go to the following great locations and fill out an entry form. Bon appetit.
Come to Vito's Birch Mountain Inn on Villa Luisa Road in Bolton. And while you're there, enter to win dinner and a movie.
True Value Hardware in Wethersfield on the Silas Dean Highway, or True Value Hardware in Cromwell on Shunpike Road. And don't forget all your fall cleanup needs at True Value Hardware.